I went to Northeastern University in Boston in the 1970s. There was a girl in my biology class who was very thin and who coughed incessantly. Why doesn't she leave the class? She is so disruptive, were my thoughts. I did eventually get to know her, and we became friends. I found out that she coughed because she had a buildup of mucus in her lungs. She had a disease called cystic fibrosis. Andrina's roommate used to pound on her lungs to break up the mucus that would accumulate. Andrina and I sat next to each other during a graduation in the Boston Garden. Her last name also began with N. Andrina made it into graduate school and enrolled in a master's degree program in Venezuela. However, just 1 year into her program, she became very sick and passed away. I have never forgotten her. She has always been a tenacious inspiration. Cystic fibrosis is most common in Caucasian Americans and is the least common in Asian Americans. Andrina was Hispanic. CF is even more common in carriers, or people who don't have the disease but that carry the recessive gene. This Punnett square shows that CF is a recessive genetic disease that is inherited approximately 25% of the time in the offspring of parents who carry the gene for CF. The gene for causing cystic fibrosis is located on chromosome 7. The location was not known in Andreina's time. There have been almost 2,000 mutations in the CF gene that have been discovered, with a few being the most common. Symptoms of CF can include very salty tasting skin, persistent coughing, the body's effort to break up the mucus accumulations, wheezing or shortness of breath, frequent lung infections, including pneumonia or bronchitis. Different bacteria infect the lungs during different times of the lifespan, and many bacteria develop antibiotic resistance, which can eventually lead to the demise of the patient. Other symptoms include poor growth or the inability to gain weight in spite of good appetite, greasy stools, and male infertility. Often the vas deferens simply do not even develop. We now know that a correct version of the CF gene codes for a transmembrane regulator protein, or CFTR. A mutant form of CFTR will block channels that allow ions into and out of the cell and that are important for water balance. Chloride ions and water build up on one side of the cell membrane and a sticky mucus forms on the other side. This CFTR protein, when normal, helps to ensure that there is a proper balance of chloride ions on both sides of the membrane. Therapies now include nebulizers, inhalers, and antibiotics, and a whole host of other drugs, many for digestion. Some medicines that are being experimented with are CFTR protein modulators that can help open those chloride channels. The life expectancy for someone with CF is 37, but some people are living well into their 50s. We are hoping for an eventual cure for this disease.
Start again, start again. Begin, start again, everyone. Open book, open world. We don't know what will come, we just hope everyone. Say goodbye to our old life. It's a brand